Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways that you can make money online working from home. So I want to say thank you to all of you for your support the past few weeks. I had surgery on my throat and I wasn't able to speak, and as you can tell, I'm getting my voice back slowly but surely. So one of the things I love about working online is that there are many different passive income opportunities. And for the past few weeks, I wasn't able to do any work, but I was earning an income. I was earning an income from my YouTube videos, from the ad revenue, but also passive income from Etsy. And what Etsy is a platform where you can sell both physical products and digital products. I have a playlist of different Etsy tutorials that I will link you to in the description below this video. But in today's video, I want to talk to you about how you can create your own digital printables to sell on Etsy. I'm going to give you ideas of what kind of printables you can create and sell on Etsy. We're going to go on Etsy and look at some examples of successful printables and successful shops. And I'm also going to teach you step by step how to create a printable that is ready for you to upload on Etsy and sell. Now we're going to be using Canva to create this printable, and Canva is 100% free. I've linked you to my referral link in the description below if you want to sign up. And I'm going to teach you step by step how to create this as an example. This is just an example, so use this as inspiration. But what this is it's a bachelorette game for a bachelorette party. And I could not believe how many people are selling printables like this for $5. And it's just one piece of paper. And theirs aren't even pretty like this one. So if you create something that's even more beautiful than what you find on Etsy and sell it for less money, you're sure to get some sales. So I'm going to show you how to create this, design this, how to put a watermark on it so people can't steal your worksheets. And I'm hoping that this video will give you some inspiration for starting your own Etsy shop. So before we get started, make sure to like this video, subscribe for more tutorials on how to make money online, and let's get started. So first of all, I want to show you, this is my Etsy playlist, and I've linked you to this playlist in the description below this video. I have a few different tutorials on how to get started setting up an Etsy shop and also how to create Etsy listing photos for free. So make sure to check out this if you want more tutorials on how to use Etsy. I also want to show you some proof that I actually have earned money on Etsy. So I'm not just telling you about an idea that you could do. I'm telling you that I have done it and I have made money on Etsy. So I have earned almost $14,000 on Etsy. You can see that I've had 3,550 different sales. So this is within the past 5 years, and I have 15 different printables that I put up 5 years ago, and I've done nothing ever since. So I literally don't do anything. I just respond to messages if someone has troubles accessing their file or downloading their file. And aside from that, I don't do anything. This is actually something this year I want to do more of, because I think I could make much more money if I uploaded more printables. And now let's talk about what kind of printable ideas are out there. So if you go on Etsy and you type in digital printables, you can see there are millions of results. And you might say, well, how am I supposed to compete with these people? Well, you can compete with them. In my niche, there are other people selling the same product and I'm making money. Because when people are looking, sometimes they get really specific about what they're looking for. Let's say single female wall art, for example. And you can see that narrows it down a bit. Or maybe inspirational quotes wall art for single women, for example. That really narrows it down to 199 results. So depending on what people are putting here with their keywords, you can get all sorts of different options that they will browse through and decide which one that they want to purchase. So what I decided I want to show you how to create today is, I have a friend of mine who's getting married, and I was shown a printable from Etsy on bachelorette party games. And a bachelorette party is basically before a woman gets married, her friends will have a party for her and they'll play all sorts of silly little games. Now you can have clean bachelorette party games, which is something you can sell. Or there's more, you know, dirty party games where they make dirty jokes and whatnot. So if I type in clean bachelorette party games, you can see this one, 8 clean bachelorette party games. Click on that. This person is selling 8 different games. I love her thumbnail. It shows you exactly what you're getting. This is so easy to create. And she's charging, I guess that's $10 for this. And you can see how many sales she has, over 6,000 sales. It's just a digital download. Romantic movies emoji game. Guess the romantic movies written with emojis. Like, look at this.
She also includes the answer key. And this is so easy to create. And you might say, well, why don't these people just create them themselves rather than purchasing it? Well, for one person, $10 is a lot of money. But for a person who makes $100,000 a year, $10 is nothing. And their time is worth more than that. And so they would rather spend $10 and have 8 different games ready for them for their party than sit there and spend an hour or 2 hours creating their own printables. And sometimes you don't even have to upload a bundle. This person just has one page and she's selling this for $2. This one, Dirty Emoji Pictionary. This one is super popular. She's selling it for $5. Old time dirty sayings. It's basically old expressions in the past that were inappropriate and what they mean now. And it's a silly party game. She includes the answers. And look how many people have purchased this and have all these excellent reviews. So this is a great niche to get into: bachelor parties, bachelorette parties, baby showers, wedding showers. And I'm going to show you exactly how you can create a printable like this completely for free. So let's get started. Okay, so now we're going to create a printable that we can sell on Etsy. The first thing we're going to do is go to Canva. Canva is completely free to use and to download. You don't have to pay anything. If you want to sign up to Canva, just click on the link in the description below this video and you can use my referral link. So we're going to go to Creative Design and we're going to go to Custom Size. So the first thing we're going to do is change this to inches and then put 8.5 for the width and 11 inches for the height because that's the standard paper size, and then click Create New Design. Okay, so we're going to make a much more beautiful version of this. So this is someone's bridal shower game, he said, she said. Basically, this is a bridal shower game. All the guests have to guess what the bride says, if the bride says who is a better driver, her or the groom. So the first thing we're going to do is click here on text. Let's click add a heading. We're going to type in, well, let's say bachelorette games. Maybe you would want to do he said, she said. Triple click to highlight everything. And we're going to use this font here, Stoic, I think it is. Yep, Stoic. To adjust the font size, you can just click and drag on this handle or adjust it by going up and down here. To zoom up on your document, you can just slide this down here. That way, it'll be easier for us to see. Next thing we're going to do is add a line. I'm going to click on Elements, type in Line, click here on Line, and we're going to make a separation line up at the top here. You can just click and drag to make the line longer. And then I'm going to click on this box here to change the line color. Let's make it a blue color. And then we can click here and I'm going to make it with these little points. And then you can choose how thick you want it to be. And then actually I'm going to click on the text, right click, bring to front. Now I want to add a little graphic. Let's type in rings or wedding or whatever. This graphic is free. All of these graphics are free except for the ones that say pro. So just click on the graphic to add it to your document. And then we can adjust the size. We can even change the color. So just click on the box to change whatever color you want. And then you can just adjust the size of the element. So let's say I want to do something like this, bachelorette game. Now we're ready to add our text. We're going to go over here to text, click add a little body of text. You can choose whatever font you want. And we're going to add the questions to our game. So for example, who picks the worst movies? And then you can even bold in some of it if you want. What we're going to do is go back to elements and type in numbers. And you don't have to do this. You could just say, you know, one dot, who picks the worst movies. But if you want to make it prettier and more pleasing to the eye, let's add some graphics. Because this person, for example, no, they don't have any numbers. It's kind of basic. So here under graphics, click see all. And you can choose any number style that you like. I chose this one here. And we can change the color. Let's make it match our document. And just click and drag to make it smaller. Now what we can do is click and drag. So we highlight both of these so we can move them at the same time. So we have to move it over a little bit. And now we want to add in the male or female symbol. So let's go male symbol, something to represent the groom and the bride that they can circle. So let's say we do that and then the female symbol. Now, this of course would only work if it was a bride and a groom. And obviously, you know, in marriages, it could be two grooms or two brides. So actually making sure that you have a document or multiple documents that represent all types of couples is great. So let's say it is two grooms. Maybe you'd have two grooms like this, and then you would change the color of one, and then they could decide, okay, the orange groom is Steve and the blue groom is Chad or something like that. And when you offer multiple options like this, it's a great way to get more sales as well, because there are many different types of people who are getting married. So that's just what you could do. But in this case, we're just going to do the bride and the groom. And then now we would click and drag to highlight all of this, control C to copy, control V to paste. And we're going to put in our next question and just come up with any questions that you think are fun or funny. Of course, you don't want to just copy everyone else. You want to come up with something original. And then for the numbers, you're going to have to erase this by clicking delete and then typing in numbers. And this part is a little tedious because you'll have to go through and find all the different numbers yourself. But then you can use the same template to make other printables as well. So the most difficult printable you make will be the first one. So again, you'll just keep going through, copying and pasting and doing all of that with all your different questions. And then at the bottom, maybe you want to put a final score or something. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click and drag on the first title and the line, control C to copy, go down here, control V to paste. And then maybe I'd put something like the final score, so you can see who's going to be the winner of the game. And then you could put, let's say, a circle out of 9, for example, or however many questions it is. And you could do something like that. So your end result would be something like this, bachelorette games, and you can see all the different questions. And basically, this would be a party game that people can circle, whether it's the male or the female, the bride or the groom, who picks the worst movies or makes the first move. I think mine looks much more professional than this one does, just the font and everything else. And so what you would also can add to even increase your chances of getting more sales is you're going to click here on add page. And what we're going to do is this right here would cover one entire sheet of paper. And if someone wanted to save on paper and not print off, you know, 15 different pieces of paper, especially if this is a party game and there's lots of different people at the party, is split the paper into four sections. So how we can do this is scroll down to the page 2 and then go to elements and click here on lines and shapes, or you can type in rectangle and click add a shape. And we're gonna go like this and basically try to, there we go, make it so it fills a quarter of the page. Then here, under border style, we're going to add a border. So let's say we've got a black border or a blue border or whatever. And then click on the blue icon and just choose no background. So we've got this here. And we're going to go control C to copy, control V to paste. And we're just going to paste it like this. Keep copying and pasting it so it fills the entire page. And then we can copy this 4 times down here. So to do that, we're going to click over on the side and highlight everything on the page. Then we're going to right click and go group. And now it's all in one group. And if you make a mistake, you can just right click here to go to undo. Now we're going to click on the group, control C to copy, then control V to paste, and just make this really small so it fills this section right here. Okay, and that way when someone is printing this off, they can print off 4 copies of the game. So then we're going to click on the group again, control C to copy, control V to paste, and just paste this 4 times. And you can get rid of this little line down here or make it smaller. And the last thing you want to do is add an answer key or the game instructions or both. So let's say game instructions, the bride or groom must fill out this sheet. They must circle whether the bride or groom is the person who performed or performs the action. Then I've got an example and more instructions. And if it's an answer key to the game, you would provide that here. And it all just looks super professional. So if we zoom out, you can see that we have 1, 2, 3 pages of a document that these people will be buying for whatever, you know, you're selling this for $1, $2 or whatever. So to download this file so that you can upload it to Etsy and people can buy it is click share, download, and we're going to click flatten PDF and download it as PDF standard and then download. And we click on it and you can see how cute this file looks that we just made. It's so much nicer than this one. And this one, look at all the sales they're getting he said, she said. It's really amazing how easy it is to make these beautiful printables. And one thing that this person should have done and that they didn't do is they didn't put a watermark on it. So someone could literally right click and go save image or copy image and just steal this so they don't have to buy it. Like, look, she's pretty much giving away the entire PDF for free. So what you should really do to avoid people just stealing this is put a watermark on your printable and that way they can't just copy it. And to do that, we're gonna go to text, click on add a heading, choose a nice thick font, something like this, watermark, or you can put the name of your printable store, change the color to like gray or something. Then over here, click on transparency, bring the transparency down to something like this. So if it's not too light, they still might steal it. But if it's nice and thick like that, you can see, okay, this is a cool game, but I'm going to pay so I can remove this annoying watermark. And then you could, you know, download this as a PNG file, and then you can upload this image right here for your listing. And that way someone's not going to just steal your file. Okay, so I really hope this inspired you guys a little bit. I actually had a lot of fun creating this and I'm starting to get really excited for creating more printables for my own Etsy shop because it's just so simple to do. And when you see all the printables on Etsy that are making money and you know you can create something better, you know, why not try? So thank you guys so much for watching this video. I will try to do more videos about Etsy because I just think it's an amazing platform for people to make money online. Make sure to like this video if you enjoyed it, and I will see you in my next tutorial.